Welcome student in third session from your textbook chapter number 8 motion. Today we will continue this chapter. In last session we study about the distance travel and displacement and uniform motion and non-uniform motion. So today we are going to discuss about the speed. If a car is running slow, we say that its speed is low. And if a car is running fast, then we say that its speed is high. So thus the speed of a body gives us an idea of how slow or fast that body is moving. Okay, so we can define that speed of a body is the distance traveled by it per unit time. Okay, so the speed of a body can be calculated by dividing the distance traveled and by the time taken, okay, to travel this distance. So the formula for speed can be speed is equal to distance traveled upon time taken. Here that is speed. If a body travels a distance s, okay, in time t, then its speed is v, is given by v is equal to s upon t. So where v is what? Speed. S means distance travel and t means time taken to travel the that distance. Okay, so the SI unit of speed is meter per second or meter per second. Okay, like that, any small values that centimeter per second and high speed of value kilometer per hour. Okay, so it is a scalar quantity. Okay, speed is what? Scalar quantity. So the speed of a running car at any instant of time is shown by an instrument is called the speedometer. Okay, means which is fixed in the car, means ye speedometer rehta hai wo car mein fixed rehta hai. Okay, and that the speedometer gives us the speed in kilometer per hour. Okay, the distance traveled by a car is measured by another instrument called that odometer. Okay, which is also installed in the car. It records the distance in kilometer. Now about the velocity. The speed of a car or any other body gives us an idea of how fast the car is moving, but it does not tell us the direction in which the car is moving. Okay, so we should know the speed of the car as well as the direction of speed. This gives us another term known as the velocity. Okay, so which can define that velocity of a body is the distance traveled by it per unit time in a given direction. So that is called the velocity. Means isme distance travel ke sath mein direction bhi mention rehti hai, to use kya kehte hain, velocity. So that velocity is equal to distance travel in a given direction upon time taken. So if a body travels a distance s, okay, and in time t in a given direction, then its velocity v and is given by v is equal to s upon t. So where v is what? Velocity of the body. S means that distance traveled in given direction. Okay, t means time taken to travel the distance. So we know that the distance travel in a given direction is known as displacement. Velocity of a body is the displacement produced per unit time. Another formula for velocity is velocity is equal to displacement upon the time taken. And same formula, v is equal to s upon t. So the SI unit of velocity is the same as that of the speed, namely meters per second. Okay, meter per second, kilometer per hour, bigger value of that velocity, and centimeter per second to express the small values of the velocity. So the difference between the speed and velocity is that speed has only magnitude. Speed mein only kya rehta hai? Magnitude rehta hai. It has no specific direction. It has no specific koi bhi direction nahi tha. But velocity has a magnitude as well as the direction. Means aap simply agar dekhoge to velocity aur speed dono same. Okay, but there is a difference. So but velocity has magnitude as well as the direction. Clear this one? So in fact velocity of a body is its speed in a specified direction. Okay, so speed is a scalar quantity, but velocity is a vector quantity. Okay, because in that magnitude as well as direction is also mentioned is there. Okay, now types of velocity. There is three types of velocity is mentioned here: uniform velocity, non-uniform velocity, and average velocity. So first that uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means or constant velocity. Okay, if an object travels in a specified direction in a straight line, okay, and moves the same distance every second. So we say that its velocity is what? Uniform. Okay. When a body covers equal distance, okay, in equal interval of time in a straight line, okay, in given direction, so that is called the uniform velocity. Now uniform velocity, when a body covers unequal distance, okay, जब body unequal distance cover करती है in a equal interval of time, not in a straight line, means straight line में नहीं करती, okay, not in given direction, so that is called the non-uniform velocity. For example, car running towards north on busy road with variable velocity. Variable velocity means when the body does not cover equal distance in equal interval of time, okay. And the velocity is said to be variable or non-uniform velocity. In this case, the speed of the body is not constant. Means busy road पे आपने देखा होगा जब ज़्यादा भीड़ रहती है तो गाड़ी स्लो करनी पड़ती है, फिर जब क्लीन रोड रहता है फिर फास्ट मूविंग करती है. इसमें इट मीन्स दैट वेरिएबल स्पीड कैसी रहती है, उसमें वेरिएबल रहती है. ओके, सो इवन इफ द स्पीड ऑफ ए बॉडी इज कॉन्स्टेंट बट द डायरेक्शन इज चेंजिंग, द वेलोसिटी विल नॉट बी यूनिफॉर्म. सपोज अ कार इज मूविंग ऑन ए सर्कुलर रोड विथ कॉन्स्टेंट स्पीड, सो नाउ दो द स्पीड ऑफ द कार इज कॉन्स्टेंट, इट्स वेलोसिटी इज नॉट कॉन्स्टेंट बिकॉज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ ए कार इज चेंजिंग कंटिन्यूअसली. ओके, now next is average velocity. okay, if the velocity of a body is always changing, velocity changing होती रहती है but changing at a uniform rate, और कैसे हो रही है, uniform rate, then the average velocity is given by the arithmetic mean of the initial velocity and final velocity. okay, for a given period of time, that is average velocity, okay, is equal to initial velocity plus final velocity upon 2. okay, so here v bar is equal to u plus v upon 2, means here where v bar, okay, denotes the average velocity, u is the initial velocity and v is the final velocity. okay, this formula for calculating the average velocity will be helpful in solving the numerical problem. okay, this formula is help in solving the numerical problem, so it should be memorized. now next topic is acceleration. okay, when the velocity of a body is increasing, the body is said to be accelerating. okay, so acceleration of a body is defined as the rate of change of its velocity with time. okay, that is acceleration is equal to change in velocity upon time taken for change. so now the change in velocity is the difference between the final velocity and the initial velocity. okay, so that is change in velocity is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity. So that acceleration is equal to final velocity minus initial velocity, means change in velocity upon the time taken. Suppose the initial velocity of a body is u. okay, initial velocity is what? U, and it changes to final velocity is v in time t. then a is equal to v minus u upon t. okay, where a is what? Acceleration of the body, v is what? Final velocity of the body, u initial velocity of the body, and t time taken for the change in velocity, means uski jo velocity change hai jitna time laga hai, that is denoted by the t. so since acceleration is a change in velocity divided by time, therefore the unit of acceleration will be the unit of velocity, okay, meter per second. so divided by the unit of time second, thus SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. okay, so that acceleration is a vector quantity. acceleration kya hai? It is a vector quantity because in that magnitude is also there and that direction is also mentioned here. so it is clear from the definition, that is a is equal to v minus u upon t, that a body is moving with uniform velocity, its acceleration will be zero, because then the change in velocity means v minus u is zero. so thus when the velocity of body is uniform, acceleration is zero, kyunki usme jab uniform speed se chalegi to acceleration is what? Zero, because acceleration kya hai? Change in the speed. okay, means because acceleration is what? Change in velocity. and when the velocity of body is not uniform, it is changing, means okay, the motion is what? Accelerated. now uniform acceleration, the velocity of car increases, the car is said to be accelerating. If the velocity increases at a uniform rate, the acceleration is said to be uniform. A body has a uniform acceleration if it travels in a straight line and its velocity increases by equal amount in equal interval of time. Okay, in other words, when the velocity of a body undergoes equal changes in velocity in equal interval of time, for example, freely falling body, means the motion of freely falling body is an example of uniformly accelerated motion. Okay? The motion of a ball rolling down an inclined plane, okay, in an example of uniformly accelerated motion. Clear this one? Now, the velocity time graph of a body having uniformly accelerated motion in a straight line that we will study further. Now, non-uniform accelerating. Okay, a body has a non-uniform acceleration if its velocity increases by unequal amount in equal interval of time. Means उसमें velocity increases हो रही है, but कैसे? Unequal. आपने यहाँ पे देखा था velocity कैसे हो रही है? Undergoes equal changes. उसमें velocity में equal changes हो रहे हैं, और यहाँ पे कैसे हो रहे थे? Velocity में changes unequal amount. Okay. So interval of time. So that is called the non-uniform acceleration. Okay. So that example car running on a crowded road. At the moment the velocity of car increases, whereas at another moment it decreases. Means जब वो crowded road पे अगर car running करती है तो कभी उसकी velocity increase होगी और कभी क्या होगी? Decrease होगी. So the movement of car on a crowded city road is an example of non-uniform acceleration. Okay, the velocity time graph for a body having non-uniform acceleration is what? Curved line, that we will study further. Okay, means अगर straight line आएंगी तो uniform acceleration और curved line आएंगी तो non-uniform acceleration. Now next one is retardation or negative acceleration. Okay, means all meaning is same. So acceleration takes place when the velocity of body changes. अगर body की में velocity changes हो रही है तभी acceleration mention होता है. Okay. So the velocity of body may increase or decrease. Accordingly, the acceleration is of two types. Okay, positive acceleration and negative acceleration. So if the velocity of a body increases, the acceleration is what? Positive. And if the velocity of body decreases, the acceleration is negative. Agar body ki velocity increase hongi, to acceleration positive mention honga. और अगर velocity body की decrease होगी तो acceleration negative mention होगा. Body is said to be retarded if its velocity is decreasing. अगर उसकी decreasing हो रही है velocity, it means that retardation. Okay? For example, slowing down of car. Retardation is actually acceleration with the negative sign. Okay? तो इसमें जब आप इसको जब solve करते हो इससे related example, तो आपको retardation is actually acceleration with the negative sign. Clearly, simply you have to remember that if the velocity increases with time, then acceleration is what? Positive acceleration. If velocity decreases with time, then acceleration is what? Negative acceleration, or retardation or deacceleration. Means these are the same. Thank you.